Hello dear friends, in this video, we will learn how to control audio volume with slider. Actually, we are gonna learn how to control audio mixer with slider. And how to save volume settings. So, when we restart the game, the previous volume settings will be kept. Okay, let's get started. In the previous video, we learned how to use audio mixer. Today, we will create a slider and control the audio mixer with this slider. I will create a script called volume settings to provide a connection between the slider and the audio mixer. Let's create a slider first. Right click on the hierarchy panel, click on UI and slider. As you can see, when I add a slider, the canvas and event system are added automatically. I'm gonna share two detailed videos about canvas and UI systems. You can subscribe so you don't miss it. I'm gonna change the size of the slider. And you can customize the slider as you want. I wanna add a text to the slider. Right click on the slider, go to UI and click on text. Set the position of the slider. Start the game. The slider is ready. But as you can see, the slider doesn't change the volume of the music. Let's connection the slider to the audio mixer. Select canvas and I'm gonna create a script named volume settings. Open the script. I'm gonna add audio library and UI library. I created audio mixer variable named my mixer to access the audio mixer. I'm gonna create slider variable named music slider to access the volume slider. Save the script and go back to Unity. Drag and drop the music slider to here. And drag and drop the audio mixer to here. Select music group. To change the volume of the music, we have to change the volume parameter. So, we need to access the volume parameter from the volume settings script. To access a parameter of the audio mixer, we have to expose it. Right click on the volume parameter and expose it. And you can see the exposed parameters here. I'm gonna rename it to music. Using this name, we will access this parameter from the script. Go back to the script. I'm gonna create a method named setMusicVolume as public. First, get the slider value, then set volume parameter value of audio mixer to the slider value. Save and go back to Unity. Select music slider, then click the plus button. Drag and drop canvas object here, because it has volume settings script. Select volume settings script, then select set music volume method. Set music volume function will work as the slider moves. Okay, start the game and test it. As you can see, we can control the audio mixer with the slider, but it only moves between 0 and 1. Because the slider value is between 0 and 1. Audio mixer volume changes logarithmically, but the value of the slider changes linearly. I will get the logarithmic value of the slider and I will multiply it by 20. Go back to Unity. I'm gonna change the minimum value of the slider to 0.0001. Okay, start the game again. Nice! As you can see, we can control the music properly with the slider. But when the game first starts, The audio mixer is not compatible with slider. After moving the slider, it becomes compatible. I'm gonna run the set music volume function when the game starts. So, the slider and the audio mixer will be compatible. Start the game. As you can see, when the game starts, the slider and the audio mixer are compatible with each other. I turn the volume of the music to the highest level and exit the game. And when we restart the game, the music level is not at the highest level. Let's see how to save the music volume settings. I'm gonna use Player Prefs class to store player preferences. We can store string, float, and integer values by using Player Prefs class. I will store the value of the slider with the music volume key name. I'm gonna create a new method named loadValume. I will equate the slider's value to the value I have stored with the music volume key name in this method. Then I will call setMusicValume method. When the game starts, if a data named music volume key has been stored, I'm gonna run the loadValume method. If not, I'm gonna run setMusicValume method. Okay, save and back to Unity. Start the game. I will turn off the music and exit the game. Restart the game. As you can see, the music is muted. If you leave the music volume at which level, when you start the game again, the music level will remain at that level. Let's quickly create a slider for SFX2. Duplicate the music slider and rename it to SFX Slider. I will follow the same steps with the music slider. As you can see, SFX slider is working properly. You can control the volume of music and sound effects separately. Let's check the save system. Restart the game. Nice! I hope the video useful for you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.